The death toll from yesterday's fuel tank explosion in Chigogwa town, Wakiso district, has risen to 15 after 4 more people died from the injuries, the police have said. Patrick Onyango, the Kampala Metropolitan Police spokesperson, told New Vision today that 24 other people were injured, with 15 currently in the intensive care unit at Chirudu Referral Hospital in Kampala.
Nayo namba oba omuwendo guno eyinza okwongerako kubanga tukyalina abalwadde abakyali mu ICU mu mbeera embi.
He also said an investigation into the cause of the accident was underway, utilizing available technologies such as CCTV cameras to piece together what happened. The fire engulfed the vehicle registration number UAM292Q, which was traveling from Kampala to Gulu, sending flames up into the sky. It killed 11 people on the spot, including 2 children. Relatedly, Speaker of Parliament Anita Among has extended her condolences to the loved ones of the victims of a devastating oil tanker blaze in Chigogwa.
Such instances point the need for sensitizing our locals on public safety during such incidents. We condone with the families, bereaved families, and pray that may the Lord comfort them.
16 National Unity Platform NUP supporters who were last week convicted by the General Court Martial after they pleaded guilty to charges of unlawful possession of explosive devices and treachery have been sentenced to 3 months and 22 days in jail. Among those sentenced are Olivia Lutaya, Rashid Seguja, Robert Rugumayo, Muhammadin Nekakoza, Simon Kijambu, Abdul Matovu, and Mesach Chuanuka. Speaking during the sentencing at the General Court Martial, Brigadier General Freeman Mugabe said they did not waste the court's time having pleaded guilty to the offense. He further justified the sentence, saying they have families to look after and there is no known previous criminal record against them.
Therefore, after deducting the period of 3 years, 4 months and 8 days spent on remands to approach the custody, and further deducting the period of 16 months from mitigating factors, this court hereby sentences each of you as follows. Each of you is sentenced 3 months, 22 days imprisonment.
Some of the convicts were arrested in November 2020 from Kalangala district on the campaign trail of Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu alias Bobi Wine, the NUP president. On October 14th this year, the group pleaded guilty and sought a presidential pardon. Consequently, they were arraigned before the General Court Martial and charged with the unlawful possession of 13 explosive devices. In May 2021, an additional charge of treachery was slapped on them. For the 16 who never pleaded guilty to the charges, the court has adjourned their case to December 12 for further hearing. So far, 9 witnesses have testified in the matter. Uganda Communications Commission, UCC, today conducted an operation to crack down on illegal broadcasters in Kasanda District. UCC is targeting unlicensed radio stations as well as focusing on eliminating the use of megaphones, locally known as bizindalo, which are often used in public places without proper authorization. Among the items that were impounded from the illegal operators are transmitters, studio monitors, headphones, and computers. Accessories. Some of the broadcasters were remotely located and were difficult to access. According to Ibrahim Bosa, the UCC spokesperson, the illegal operators shall remain closed until they meet the requirements and minimum broadcast standards.
Business oba omulimu gw'okuweereza ebyempuliziganya basobola okutuukirira ekitongole kya Uganda Communications Commission ne baba nga balongoosa enkola yaabwe basobola okusaba community-based radio stations ne tubayamba.
He further guided the communities to follow the procedures to conduct broadcasting business.